Hello, Brownsburg High School. Thanks for watching BHS TV. Today is Wednesday, August 26th. I'm Reed Leatherman.
And I'm Blake Hall, and here are today's announcements. It's almost Riley Week. Support Riley by purchasing a teacher at all the lunches next week. You can also donate by visiting the website at the bottom of the screen. Also, don't forget that it's read out for Riley next Friday, and the tailgate before the game starts at 4:30.
Avon game t-shirts will be pre-sold this week for $10. Orders can be placed during lunch in the main cafeteria and senior cafeteria. Show your colors and support the dogs.
The Brownsburg Show Choir are sponsoring a free car wash this Saturday, August 29th from 11 to 4. Donations are accepted and appreciated. It will take place at Mowry's across from Dairy Queen.
Brownsburg High School's Chain Link Senate will be hosting a cookout at Ace Hardware across the street from Marsh this Saturday, August 29th from 10 a.m. to 2 p.m. Come get a free hot dog and make a donation to support Riley Hospital for Children.
The Fellowship of Christian Athletes would like to invite you to join them every Friday in the LGI room at 7 a.m. You do not have to be an athlete or a Christian to attend. There will be donuts, so bring a friend, and they hope to see you there.
Juniors and seniors, college mini fairs and the Senior Academy are coming up next week. Remember to take a look at the Naviance at the colleges that will be visiting BHS. In order to attend the BHS college list, you must sign up for an Naviance. You must sign up 24 hours in advance for September Wednesday college mini fairs and 48 hours in advance for our large schools auditorium visits. If you have questions, see Mrs. Mathurins or Mrs. Martin.
The next French Club meeting will be Thursday, September 7th at 3 p.m. in room H206. They will be voting on a t-shirt to sign. If you have a great idea for a teacher, please submit your design to Miss Bradley by Wednesday, September 6th.
There will be a call-out meeting for the Creative Writing Club on Thursday, September 3rd from 3 to 4 p.m. in SA 214. Anyone who enjoys writing is welcome to attend. If you have any questions, please ask Miss Lowry or Senior Charles Ganagi.
FCCLA will be meeting in G113 on Thursday, August 27th from 3 to 3:45. Join them for fun treats and to learn more about the club.
Have you ever struggled with tobacco addiction and wanted to quit? BCSC Police will be hosting tobacco-free Hendricks County to provide smoking cessation classes on Thursday, September 17th at 3 p.m. in the Senior Academy LGI. Notifying your team office if you are interested in signing up.
The Wheels Up Rider Club is having a call-out meeting tomorrow, August 27th from 3 to 4 in the Senior Academy LGI room. Any students who are interested in attending is welcome to join us. You do not have to be a rider to attend.
The Environmental Club is having a call-out meeting this Thursday, August 27th at 7:15 in room C207. This is your chance to make a difference in our school, the Brownsburg community, and the world. If you cannot attend the meeting but would like to find out more, you can see Mrs. Moeller anytime in room C207.
Are you interested in visiting the Galapagos Islands, made famous by Charles Darwin? If so, please stop by either Mr. Freeman's room, C211, or Ms. Moeller's room, C207, to pick up information sheets.
Are you interested in pursuing a career in the health field? Brownsburg will be starting a new club, HOSA, for students in biomedical, PLTW program, and other science classes. HOSA stands for Health Occupation Students of America and helps develop leadership and technical health occupation skills. If you are interested, then please attend one of the two call-out meetings on Thursday, September 3rd at 7:15 or 3 p.m. in Ms. Duncan's room, C204.
Anyone interested in wrestling this year? There will be a mandatory preseason wrestling meeting tomorrow, August 27th in Coach Snyder's room, U122. It will start at 3 p.m. sharp, so please be there on time.
We interviewed freshmen on how their high school experience is going so far. Let's see what they said. How is high school different from middle school and why?
Well, high school is fun and middle school is kind of boring for me. I don't like it.
High school is different than middle school because they got like bigger lockers. So yeah, that's a really big plus.
What's the biggest change so far and why?
My height.
There's more people because now that means there's more things that you can do and more people you get to know, more friendships.
The biggest change is definitely those bigger lockers, you know. They really do change how I think. And
has anyone helped it make easier for you so far? If so, who?
Yeah, mostly like the team leaders and my senior friend, Andy. my brother, who graduated last year.
What's the best part so far and why?
I don't really have the best. The first football game I can say is my best part so far because I actually performed then for guard and it was actually a really good show.
Best part of high school is definitely those bigger lockers. You know, it just, they really do help.
Fun part is loving high school and studying good and staying in school.
Thanks, guys. Hope you have a great year.
The Brownsburg JV Volley Dogs are now 7-0 thanks to last night's win over Plainfield. The Dogs won the match in two sets, 25-12 and 25-13. Great job, ladies.
The varsity volleyball team defeated Plainfield on Tuesday in three sets. The offensive leaders were Brooke Gregley with 9 kills, Claire Hathaway with 8 kills, and Allie Byers with 20 assists. The defense standout was Riley Kirkerley with 10 digs. The Dogs will take on the number 3 ranked HSC Royals and Fishers tomorrow night in their first conference game. Good luck.
The JV girls soccer team came out on fire against Mooresville on Monday and put together a 12-0 win. Franny Brewer recorded a shutout and goal behind solid work from all of our defensive backs. Allison Heason and Lizzie Daniels each recorded a hat trick, and Katie Percival put 2 in the back of the net. Alex Harris, Alexis Olette, Emma Fitterling, and Marty Fennell also recorded goals. Great work, Dogs.
The varsity girls soccer team battled Mooresville until the final minutes on Monday evening. Elise Cook worked extremely hard and was a threat up top, and Katie Brinkers did an outstanding job playing composed in the back. Despite a few opportunities to score, the Dogs came up short 2-0. They are back in action the first conference game at home tonight against HSC.
The girls' varsity golf team continued their winning ways with a 157-175 victory over Lafayette Jeff on Monday. Medalist Macy Stapp led the scoring with 2 over 37. One stroke behind was Darcy Brinker, carding a 38. Senior Emma Wilkins was third in shooting with a 40. Maddie Cody rounded out the scoring with a 42.
On Tuesday, they notched another win, this time over Lebanon, 155-177. The Dogs were led by medalist Maddie Cody shooting a 34. Macy Stapp shot a 39, which included her first career eagle. Morgan Keir continued her steady play, carding a 40. Abby Cody closed out the scoring with a 42.
The boys' varsity tennis team lost 4-1 at Ben Davis on Monday. Gunnar Riffick claimed the lone point with a singles win and a sweet comeback in the third set. The number 2 doubles team of Adam Pritchard and Sam Hughes played a solid doubles, losing a heartbreaker in the third set tiebreak.
The JV squad put it to the Giants with a 9-3 victory. The match format was all singles played. Wins were posted by Blake DeHart, Jack Dorman, Cade Allison, Caleb Bates, Carter Moore, Garrett Moore, Sam Vajere, Jake Petrunik, and Joe Graham. Both teams will travel to Avon tonight. Good luck.
The boys' varsity soccer was at a Hamilton Southeastern on Tuesday night. After trailing 1-0 at the half, Tyler Margetts evened the score midway through the second half. With just 9 minutes left in the game, the Royals were able to score the game winner and defeat the Dogs 2-1.
The JV boys' soccer team also found themselves trailing at half 1-0. In the second half, Mac Chase's brilliant finish, assisted by Patrick Nebeso, helped shift the momentum all the way to the end and resulted in a 1-1 tie. The boys are back in action next week against Garen Catholic.
That's all we have for you today, BHS. Thanks for watching.
See you Friday.